Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in Mythology, Preaching Christianity and Sikhism. So this parable is quite difficult, and I will give you the spiritual sense of this one after I have done this, given you the physical sense. So the spiritual sense is the right one. So this is just a practice, you know, that what applies to flesh, the opposite apply to the matters of spirit. So that I can explain that one better when I have done this physical comparison. So marriage and divorce parable, Matthew 19, part 4. Haven't you read from the scriptures? Jesus asked them, you know, to the Pharisees, Sadducees. He replied that at the beginning, the creator, Demiurge, God, Yahweh, made them male and female. He told them, you know, that a comparison that as you have male and female in physical world, similarly, we have male and female in spiritual world. Remember, the male is the Christ in you, and the female is the wisdom. So if they are the spirit. So if you subdue your spirit, or subdue your wisdom to the wisdom of God, then you are a virgin, or you are not following anybody else but of to God. So when you do so, the Christ in you will lead you through the life, and Christ will keep the predators or people who want to snatch your wife from you away, or the woman away. Woman is your spirit, or the wisdom. So in the beginning, when people were born, then they had the childlike habits. Childlike habits mean, as the child is outspoken, if you ask a child something, he will tell you bluntly the whole truth. He won't conceal anything. So that's what is sometimes when the police want to get information from the house. Then if they grab hold of a child and ask him question, they can get all the information they want. Because child will speak without any bias. So that's why Jesus said, you know, unless you become like little children, you cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. So when you get clever or grow up, then only then you start being tempted by the mammon. So then you are in a doubting stage, as I explained earlier in the Trinity. Then that is the stage when your wife or your female partner, which should be virgin, may try to leave you and go for mammon or Satan, in which you are not going anymore according to the will of our Father, but doing the will of the mammon. So you are saying the praises of the mammon. So that is then divorced, that the soul or the wisdom has divorced the soul, which is the master of the house, which is our physical body. So here is some parts, you know, which I have done before, and it gives you some idea, you know, the element which is physical element, not spiritual so much. But I will explain the spiritual one again. Now, the important genetic difference between a male and a female is that the male has XY sex chromosome pair, whilst the female has XX. So the element Y of the sex chromosome pair is called the seed, and it is used to identify the men of different races, tribes, surnames, etc. So the representation of the man or Adam is by the man, seed of the man, not by the seed of the woman. That was in the Genesis, it said that the woman was created out of the Adam's rib. That means it's a part of the Adam. So it is part of the Adam, and so that it has no surname of its own, but it has XX sex chromosome. However, this is a bit zoological question which I won't argue. Thus, these deeds of wife and children are accounted by the surname of the man only, and not by that of the woman's family. So the idea is, you know, that in spiritual also values, we have a house in which the Christ in you, in your heart, because this is the physical body, is the temple of God. And the one which is inside the temple of God, which is the priest, we call it, that priest is royal priest called Christ. So that Christ in you should be strong enough to keep the woman or the wisdom. Woman is the wisdom, Holy Spirit, a virgin, that she should not go what the princes of darkness tell him to do. That means your wisdom, you should remain solidly in God and not follow anybody else. And once you follow anybody else, then you are no more virgin. Say, for example, people follow Pope. So those people who follow Pope, their wisdom is no more following the will of our Father, but the will of the Pope. So then they become a prostitute, are unfaithful to the Christ which is inside your heart. So you should remain faithful to your inner man, the Christ, so if you want to remain virgin. Otherwise, people will grab you and make you their follower, like Pope is making the following, and so many church people are being having this problem also. These corrupt bishops and other things, televangelists, they form so much following of the blind. Only the blind follow other. So this is the age of Christ, in which you should go by your own inner man. And to go by your inner man, you must get your inner man educated in gospel, because gospel is the food for the inner man, not the bread and butter. So the Antichrist will feed sugar-coated tablets of falsehood that is very attractive, whereas the Christ in you resist, that don't do it, go by the will of our Father. If you obey your Christ which is inside you, then he keeps you virgin and solitary. Otherwise, you follow the wide road with the wide gates that leads to hell. So in the next video, I will try to explain further because this is a very difficult